So finally, GPT-5 has been officially launched by OpenAI, and in this video, we are going to compare GPT-5 with the existing ChatGPT model, which is GPT-4o. So I am going to use 4o model in ChatGPT itself. I haven't got that update yet. As you can see, what model are you? And if I search this prompt, I am still getting the response from the 4o model. As you can see, it's from 4o, and for using the GPT-5, I am in my OpenAI API playground, and here I just switched the model to GPT-5. And apart from that, here we are having multiple models, which is GPT-5 Nano, GPT-5 Mini. We are having GPT-5 Chat latest also. So I'll be giving lot of coding prompts, math problem, and even deep code problems to compare both. So let's see what it gives the output. So first, let's go with a simple prompt. This is quite a famous prompt also. This is basically a HTML code that shows a ball bouncing inside a spinning rectangle. And that particular ball needs to be affected by the friction and gravity when that rectangle rotates also. Let's see what both the model gives for this. So we have got the response from GPT-4o. I will just copy it, and here I'm having an online HTML viewer, pasting it over here. And it has done an amazing job, to be honest, over here. Only thing is, there are some times it's just bouncing too much. As you can see, right, it's bouncing way too much, and some small, you know, movement issues. But apart from that, it looks so perfect, because earlier when I tried with many other models, either the ball will fall out of the rectangle, but this has done quite an impressive job. So now let's go with GPT-5. I've got the response over here, and these are the settings I'm going with, just the default one. I haven't changed anything over here. Pasting it, and this is what I get, and it's so perfect. Just look at the difference, right? Exact same prompt, and this literally summarizes the major update between GPT-4 and GPT-5, because both the models are almost perfect. Like, they could handle any prompt and generate it. But the main difference is this small touches. As you can see, this is just a plain rectangle and a ball. Doesn't look that attractive, right? And this is what GPT-5 has done. The rectangle and the ball looks way better. And here the background color doesn't have anything separately. Here we are having a separate background color inside the rectangle. And look at that ball. It's having a white shine and looks way attractive. And here it's also having a note. Click to toss the ball. So if I click, the ball will toss. I'm clicking here. As you can see, the ball is literally spawning from that point. That looks good. Even if I click here, it's literally spawning from that particular location inside the rectangle. So some small additional touches like this makes a model close to AGI. That's what I feel about it. Let's go with the second prompt. This is creating a HTML code for rain with lightning effect, and this must be hyper realistic. Let's see what both the model gives. So we have got the response from GPT-4, copying the code, and let's see what it has given us. Okay, that looks good. I really like the rain effect. Okay, that's the maximum lightning it has generated. It's just a blink, as you can see, right? Like turning on and off a light. It doesn't generate that hyper realistic zigzag thunder effect. So many models actually generated that. Even the 120B model could generate that. And now let's see what GPT-5 has given for this. Okay, it has done a good job, but the only thing that I find weird is the rain is horizontal and the lightning effect is perfect. This is what I meant by perfect lightning effect, because in the GPT-4o, there wasn't any lightning effect at all. It was mostly like a turn off light mode. It wasn't even realistic, but just look at the lightning. This is perfect. Like, even the real lightning would be as realistic as it. And I really like the water effect that is appearing over here. So let's move on to the next prompt. This is going to be coding a big bird using HTML and show the side view of the bird flying. Let's see what it gives now. And we have got the output from GPT-4o. Copying it, going here and pasting it. Okay, that bird looks good, but the only thing is it's going in reverse. And most of the prompts, most of the models that I have tried, everything has the same issue. Like the bird is going in reverse. The head should come on front. Like this is a common problem that I see. And just look at the number of lines of code that I get. And just compare it with GPT-4. That's it. And just look, I guess it has generated 2 to 3 times the number of code when compared to GPT-4. And now let's see the output. And this is what I get in the output. Just look at the extra details over here. The clouds, the sun, and the bird looks perfect. The only thing I see negative is the bird is not moving at all. It's not moving forward, but it has this flight speed, flap speed. If I go it to high, it's flapping much faster. Size, so we're having the pause and resume also. So just look at the additional features that it has got. And look at this and look at this. It's almost like 100 times better than the previous one. So now let's go with the math problem. This is the one that I'm going to ask. Kind of hard. Let's see what both the model can do for this. And the correct answer for this question is C, which is 4 root 3 minus 6. And GPT-5 has done it perfectly. Let's see what this has given. And GPT-4o has given the answer as 6 minus 4 root 3, which is the wrong answer. And after giving the correction prompt, I just said this is wrong answer, corrected. Now it has given the right answer. So that's how good GPT-5 model is in terms of math problems. Even the hardest problems, it's able to solve it easily. So let's go with the lead code hard problem. First, missing positive, and this just has an acceptance rate of 41%. So quite hard problem. Let's see what both the model gives for this. We have got the response. Let's go with GPT-4 model, and we can just copy the function, pasting it over here. Yep, that's good. Submit it. And in the runtime, it beats 100%. That's insane. And in the memory, it beats 23%. So that's on a lower side. Let's see what GPT-5 is going to do for this. And this has also given 100% and 27%. I guess GPT was 24% or something, 3% extra. Let's go with another difficult problem also. This time I'm going with the crazy hard problem, strong password checker, because the acceptance rate is just 15%. Okay, it's going to be a crazy challenge. Let's see what both the model does for this. Let me copy this. Okay, it has got a wrong answer over here. The number of test cases that has passed is 44 out of 54. That's almost like 80% it has passed. It has done a good job, but here it just fails. And it has given the output also. Let's see how better it is. And just look at the difference over here. It beats with 100% runtime, and in memory, it has got 85%. So this single problem sums up the difference between GPT-4 and GPT-5 in terms of coding, not only in solving simple problems, but also like creating an entire web app from scratch. There also GPT-5 excels. So that's the conclusion, guys. Do let me know what you think. Check the playlist of my channel. Learn a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.